Hi everyone and welcome to our Breakfast at Nine service online from here in Weymouth. I hope you're all doing well. It's great to have you join us this morning. If you're new here, then a really big welcome and don't forget to check out our Facebook page. We would love to connect with you on there. My name is Laura.
And I'm the Reverend Matt. I'm the curate here serving the parish of Redipol on Malcolm Regis. I do hope that you are having a yummy, scrummy breakfast this morning, or enjoying whatever you're eating or drinking as you watch this. This week, my question to you, all of us, is what is your favourite book? Well, my favourite book next to the Bible is The Hobbit. And if you want a really good book to read over the summer, I really recommend it. Now, I wonder what Laura's is. So, Laura, what's your favourite book?
Ooh, my favourite book. Well, other than the Bible, I like Lord of the Rings, I like Harry Potter, and I like anything that makes me laugh. This week, we're continuing to look at Jesus' parables, and parables is just another word for story. Jesus used stories to help teach us what it is to follow God. Jesus' stories are always filled with lots of different things, and each time we hear them, we can learn something new. This week, we're looking at the parable of the tenants. It's found in Matthew, but we'll hear more about that later with the story and Matt's talk. So as we begin our service today, we're just going to take a moment to think about our week and to say sorry to God for all those times that we have got things wrong, either wrong with God or wrong with others. So let's pray. For all the times we make you feel sad, we want to say sorry, God. For the times when we lie and cheat, we want to say sorry, God. For the times when we are angry and grumpy, we want to say sorry, God. For the times when we are rude or naughty, we want to say sorry, God. For the times when we deliberately disobey you, we want to say sorry, God. For the times when we are selfish or unkind, we want to say sorry, God. For all the wrong things we do, we want to say sorry, God. Amen. And so knowing that we are okay with God, that God loves us and forgives us, we're now going to join together in some songs. So why don't you stand up, have a dance, and let's worship God together.
Oh, oh you are my true north. Oh, oh you are my true north. my heart, 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 you are my true north. I will follow you into the dark, 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 you are my true north. I will follow you with all my heart, 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 you are my true north.
Talents, which can be found in your Bibles in Matthew 25, verses 14 to 30. There was a man who went on a journey. He called his servants to him and gave them his money to take care of. To one he gave 5 bags of gold. To another he gave 2 bags of gold. And to the other man he gave 1 bag of gold, depending on their abilities. Then he went off on his journey. The first man, who had been given 5 bags of gold, went straight to work and doubled his master's investment, so he now had 10 bags of gold. The second man, who had been given 2 bags of gold, did the same and ended up with 4 bags of gold. But the third man, who had been given 1 bag of gold, hid his master's money by burying it in a hole in the ground. After a long time, their master came back home and went to see them. The first man said, "You entrusted me with 5 bags of gold, and I've now got 5 more for you." "Well done," said his master, "you did your job well." The second man said, "You entrusted me with 2 bags of gold, and I've now got 2 more for you." "Well done," said his master, "you also did your job well." But the third man said, "Master, I know you have high standards and demand the best, and I was scared that I might disappoint you, so I took your money and hid it in the ground. Here it is for you." The master was really angry. "You lazy servant," he said. "If you knew I was after the best, why did you do less than the least? The least you could have done was put it on deposit with the bankers so that when I returned, I would have received it back with interest. So take the 1 bag of gold and give it to the servant with the most gold. For whoever has will be given more, and they will have an abundance."
Let me start with a question. Who likes to get presents? Yeah, I think all of us love to get presents. And if I asked you to tell me your favourite present of all time, I'm sure you'd be able to tell me. Now, one thing you might not know about me is that I love to play games, especially board games. Well, last Christmas, my lovely parents-in-law, and if you're watching, hello, brought me this game. It's called Ticket to Ride, and it's a brilliant board game. And if you hadn't guessed, it's all about building railways. And the person who builds the biggest and the best railway normally wins. Now, I love playing this game with my family and my friends because it means we spend time together and have fun together. Now, in today's story from Jesus, we hear about a bunch of servants who are given some money to look after. Now, they have a choice to do something with it. They can keep it to themselves or be generous and share it and use it. The reaction they get from their master is directly connected with the choices that they make. So you might be asking yourself, well, what's that story that Jesus told so many years ago have to do with today? I'm sure for most of us, none of us have been handed a big bucket of money recently. And if you have, let me know. The first thing to say about this story is that the master is God and that we are the servants in this story. God has given us all gifts, things that we are good at, skills and talents that God wants us to use to benefit not only ourselves, but others too. And the second thing to say about this story is that it's really not about money, even though that's what Jesus is talking about. I've heard some people say that if you follow Jesus, that you'll never have money worries again. And that by following God, you somehow have access to a heavenly bank account that never runs empty. Well, I'm afraid to say that's simply not true. But this story is about being generous with all that we have been given. It's about using the gifts, the talents that God has generously given to each of us and asking the question of us, what do we do with them? Do we just keep them to ourselves, or do we try and bless others with them? Now, God has given each of us those things we are good at. Now, I'm no good at drawing. In fact, I'm pretty hopeless and rubbish at it. On a good day, I can just about draw a stick person. But my daughter, Millie, she is a lovely, wonderful artist. Now, if I need to have a picture drawn to bless someone, I'm not going to be the one drawing it. I'm going to ask Millie to draw it because I know that she's gifted in drawing. And actually, I'm asking her to share her gift that God has given her with someone else. And going back to my board game, it needs 2 to 5 people to play it. I'm to share that gift with others so that both the people who play it and myself get the enjoyment of using it. I could be like the servant who buried the money and put the game back on the shelf and never play with it. But then I'm not using it properly. And God calls us to take that gift off the shelf, play with it, use it, and enjoy it. God doesn't want us to bury or hide our gifts that he's given us. God wants us to share them and be generous with them. Use the gifts we have been given to help benefit others. So today, let's just take a moment and think about what gifts God has given you. What talents, what skills has God blessed you with? And then ask the question, how can I be generous with all that God has given me? Let me just pray for us. Lord Jesus Christ, we thank you that you are generous to us. Thank you for all the good things you give us. We thank you that you made us all so wonderfully unique. We thank you for all the gifts, the talents, the skills, the abilities that you have blessed us with. Help us to bless others with them. Help us to not be greedy and hide them and keep them to ourselves. Help us to be generous with all that you have given us. And Lord Jesus, at this time with all the strangeness going on around us, help us to be better neighbours, better friends, better family members with all those gifts and talents that you've given us. Help us to look out for each other at this time. We think of all those who need our help at this time, those that are poorly or scared or anxious. We pray for all those who are looking after people who are poorly at the moment. We thank you for our nurses and our doctors. We thank you for all the medical staff and those that help them. And we pray for our government at this time. We pray for all those that lead us, those making decisions, that you will give them the gifts and the talents and the skills that they need to bless us. So Lord God, be with us all this day. Amen. And now let's join together in the family prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. And now it's time for our craft.
Hi everyone. So in the story that Jesus told this week, we have been learning about how we should use our gifts and our talents to bless other people. Was that right? Is that what that is? Okay, in the story that Jesus told this week, been learning about. Okay, was that right? What you said? Okay, let's do it again. Ready? Smile. Hi everyone. So, in the story that Jesus told this week, we have been learning about how we should use the gifts and talents that that God has given us. No, I've done it again. Okay, one more time. We'll get it this time. I hate this bit.
Three.
Okay, smile. Okay. Hi everyone. So in the story that Jesus told this week, we have been learning about how we should use the gifts and the talents that God has given us to bless other people. So we are going to make a craft to remind us of that. So we've got a glass jar, we're going to decorate it, and then inside we've got some little circles that where we're going to think about what our gifts and talents are and how we could bless other people with those. So first of all, girls, I'm going to get you to write my talents on the front of the jar. So I'll put it here. That's fine. You don't need a big jar unless you're going to fit it with a lot of circles. So which colour are you going to have? You choose and write my talents while I explain to everybody else about the circles. So all I did for the circles was I took a piece of card, I concertinaed it up as much as I could. I drew round something. Where's what I drew round? I found a little gem that looked the right size.
It's mine.
So I drew round.
I got it for a birthday party.
You did. I drew round that and then I cut it out. So then obviously I got a couple of circles at a time rather than cutting out lots. So that's how I did the circles. Well done. Nice and big, girls, so that you can see it. Remind you what it is you've put in the jar. Now the girls are just going to write my talents for now. But I then used some stickers and kind of decorated it around the outside as well. We'll take a picture at the end to show you what we've done. You done that?
No.
Okay, so once we've done that, we'll decorate it a little bit more. If we put this round for everyone to see, we'll decorate that a little bit. We'll do a bit more later, Jessica. Okay, we're going to move on to the little cards now. Hi. So, girls, I want you to have a think about something you're good at. Now, it doesn't have to be just things that you're good at. For example, the little ones in here say music, they say listening, and it says good friends. So it can be things that you're good at, like music or art or sewing or drawing or whatever, gardening. But it could also be other gifts that God's given you. Maybe you're a really good listener, or you're really funny and you cheer people up, or you're a good friend. It could be anything like that at all. Whatever gifts and talents you think God has given you. Okay, so can you girls just think of one thing and write it? Where's our pens? Write it on there. Also, then I've decorated it. I've just done a little wiggly circle around the outside just to make it look a bit more colourful. And then when we've done those, we'll put them into our jars. And it means that then we can get them out and we can have a think about what our gifts and talents are, and then how we can use those to bless other people. Mm-hmm. What are you going to do then, Millie? You don't have to tell everybody if you don't want to. What are you going to do? You're good at lots of things. What are you good at? What are you going to write, Jessica?
I don't want.
Okay, just do a quick one. Just one. Come on, just think of something. Singing. You're good at lots of things. Singing? Good.
Wait, I can get.
You're going to write good friend too, are you? Go on and put it there so that you can see it. That's it. Good friend. Good fry-end.
Fry-end.
That's how you spell it, isn't it? Fry-end. Yeah. And Millie is good at singing. You are very good at singing.
Thank you.
I'm good at dancing.
You are good at dancing. You could do that as another one, couldn't you? You could do good at dancing. We know that. We see you at breakfast at 9 dancing, don't we? Right. When you finish that one, girls, just put it in your pot. Well done. That one's mine. It goes in my pot. Right, Lily, have you done yours?
Wait, I'm good at gems. I'm good at gems.
Right, so put those in your pots then, girls. Now, we will finish these off, as we always do, and we will take a picture and show you our finished jars. And we'd love to see the ones that you make too, and see what your gifts are and how you think you can use them to bless other people. Right, let's say goodbye. Let's say goodbye then, girls. Bye!
There's a story of unfailing love that echoes in my heart. There's a promise that you're always here. Your word will light my path. We shall not fear the days to come. You are with. His blood poured out on Calvary.
it's been wonderful having you join us this morning for our Breakfast at Nine service, whoever and wherever you are. I hope that you have enjoyed it, enjoyed the talk and the songs and the story. And remember to connect with us on Facebook. And if you've made the craft, do show us your creations on there too. So let's just finish with a prayer. Lord Jesus Christ, you have called us to love God and love our neighbours as ourselves. Give us the Holy Spirit to help us follow your commandments and to live in peace, hope, and love. Amen. See you soon.